freshman orientation, and my orientation leader was like, dude, guys, this is going to fly by so fast. And I remember, like, roasting her in the background. I was like, no, it's not. She's just dumb. And then now I'm out here, and she was so right.
Yeah, I remember being a freshman and feeling super small. And now I'm a senior, and I'm still kind of small, but I'm bigger. So it's just crazy times. Time's gone by pretty quick.
You think 4 years are going to take forever, but they go by so quick when you actually think about it. Like, it's like yesterday, I'm a freshman, I'm like, what's going on?
Best memory was junior year. I was wearing some tight shorts, and I did this, like, kick move in the air, and I ripped my pants.
He managed to rip his pants twice in our class.
And then he just turns around, like, puts his head down and his pants just rip.
And it was scary, he was wailing out. And yeah, it was pretty bad.
A memorable moment for me was going to Santa Barbara for the college trips. Not anything in particular, just the experience and being like with your friends.
I would just say like being in class, like just like kind of like those moments where we'd like all tease each other and like we'd make fun of each other, and they were just like really fun.
I don't like talking.
That's the point of an intern.
But Alyssa Cantrell, she managed to find these little hands. She bought these hands. We made the best videos like on Snapchat, and it was so funny because she would do everything with her hands.
I think it was a San Diego field trip with Noah's birthday when, like, yeah. The waiter was talking and singing to him and dancing and stuff.
I remember in the San Diego field trip, we went to a haunted house, like, on, like, the street.
Oh.
Yeah. And so I went with Miguel and Natalie, I think. And so it was really funny because Miguel didn't want to be scared at all. And he was like, if you touch me, like, I will hurt you.
My favorite Avid moment was in eighth grade when Noah fell over in a desk and he couldn't get up.
I think I remember.
He managed to fall and he was still in his, like, desk because it was one of the full body desks. And Miss Hertenstein, got up and ran to him, but instead of actually helping him up, she started recording him and taking pictures of him.
My homie Jason was being weird, and I tried to kick him, and then I fell. And, yeah, she took a video of me. She posted it on the Avid Instagram.
Sophomore year, Santa Barbara, overnight trip, we did a scavenger hunt, and I was in Isaac's group. We were the only group that actually finished. It took a while. We were running. We were definitely running around Santa Barbara. Took a dab photo. Photo, picture. Yeah. And hashtag Team Red.
No fighting. We are the record. No fighting. Shakira, Shakira.
I never really knew that she could dance like this. She make a man wanna speak Spanish. Como se llama? Bonita. Picasso.
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh baby, when you talk like that. So be wise and keep on reading the signs of my body. I'm on tonight, you know my hips don't lie, and I'm starting to feel it's right. All the attraction, the tension, don't you see, baby, this is perfection.
Look back at it all, I'm from A. Put it right like my time sheet.
She ride it like a 63. I'ma buy a new Celine. Let her ride in the foreign with me.
I think something I'll miss the most about Avid is the unity that we all have together, that we are all together as a family. I know that's a little cliche, but it's true. We're all a family.
Just like the atmosphere when you walk into Avid, like we just like feel relaxed and comfortable.
I'm gonna miss the interaction we have, like the bond we have, and the tutors, because this is their last year also.
So I'm also miss everyone too, like just like seeing everyone like every day for like the past like couple years, like not being there, it's gonna be like weird, I guess.
Being around friends every day, just probably not being able to see their face every day.
I'm also gonna miss the tutors. Honestly, the tutors make it so much better because they tell jokes or like they'll get mad at us and we'll just laugh at them.
Brian. Yeah, just everyone. I'm just gonna miss everyone. It's been a fun 4 years. I remember I joined Avid because my mom wanted me to. And then I actually, like, I loved it, so that's why I stayed.
I'm gonna miss Ms. Fowler, Ms. Hahn, and Ms. Turnbull because, I mean, they were there for me through, like, personal and academic times. So, like, they would always push me to, like, get to where I want to be and, like, make sure that I reach where I want to go.
I'm gonna miss complaining a lot.
Oh my god. No. Her and Ms. Turnbull get in a fight at least twice a week.
Yeah, twice a week.
It's been easier on me because I've been just falling asleep in class. But I'm gonna miss complaining about Cornell notes.
Like relying on each other, like just having each other there, like knowing we're always gonna be there. I mean, we can still be there for each other, but it's not gonna be the same, like compared to seeing each other maybe once a month to like every day.
Tutors, you guys, classmates. Ms. Fowler.
The family feeling of like going to fourth period and knowing like it's the same group of people that I've been with for like 4 years, and Mrs. Fowler, who's basically like my mom.
I think I'm just gonna miss like the atmosphere in the Avid class. We all feel like we're really comfortable with each other and it feels like we're like a really close family.
The family. I mean, like, well, like we'll still be family, but like just how closely knit we are here, because we obviously, you know, we gotta go to school and we all have fourth period together, so I think just missing this, the friendship, and oh, and selling chips, that's gonna be, ha! Yeah, I wanted to be an Avid tutor next year, but it's okay, I'll be back next year, Ms. Fowler, so.
Just like the environment in general of Avid, because it's like really family-based.
I guess my favorite part that I would be missing the most would be the tutors, like April said, and I really saw some of you guys as big brothers, big sisters.
You're gonna like take for granted like seeing people every single day until you don't see them every day, and then you're like 900 miles away, and then it's like what? So yeah, I think I'm really gonna miss everyone too. I'm especially gonna miss Ms. Fowler. Ms. Fowler's like my best friend. Yeah. I tell her everything. Yeah, she always, yeah, she has her back. So it's yeah, it's gonna be hard being like in a new place without her there and like without people we know. But it's a learning experience.
This class is unique in so many ways, but having two separate classes was a little difficult from the start. I'd say the first most memorable moment was just walking in the first day with these students. I knew it was going to be challenging because they were coming from a different teacher, and I'm pretty sure they didn't really like me all that much, and so it took a little while for them to warm up. But I think we've come a really long way, and I think we can all laugh about it now, but it was a little traumatizing for me.
Top highlights would definitely be when Drew dressed up as Terry Crews in the fall lip sync battle. That was pretty epic and very hilarious. I wish I had more of that on video with him and that whistle. Say the trip to Six Flags, because you guys had worked so hard and you were so excited for that. And anything that had to do with competing against each other, you guys were phenomenal about that. That was a major strength of this group. That's where you were in it to win it all the time. If you were competing against each other, you were fight to the death, just so motivated to beat out each other. And that competitive spirit was so awesome to watch.
So this year I went through two of the hardest experiences I think I've ever had to go through as a teacher. And being with this group, I was so thankful. They reached out to me, they wrote me letters, they texted, you know, they just were there. And when I came back for the first time to visit, they literally lined up in my class to give me a hug. And that's something I'll always remember, not in a bad way, but just that they cared a lot. And that just proved to me that we really came together since sophomore year, and we kind of put all the bad blood behind us, and they were just part of my family. So I'm really, really grateful for that.
But it has been a privilege to be their teacher the last 3 years, and they have grown and matured and are ready to take on more responsibility. I really want to thank you. You guys were a great class to be around. You were fun, you were loud, you were competitive, and it was just a pleasure to be your teacher.
I love Avid.
I love Avid. Here we go, 2K18.